Hello, you beautiful divine soul. Welcome to step number 5 in our 5 steps to high frequency abundance. Today, we are talking about why band-aids and quick fixes will never work for you and why you need to get to the heart of the matter instead. So for people who are highly conscious, highly aware, intuitive and empathic, you must be in congruence energetically with your foundation in order to actually receive and bring to you and manifest everything that you want to be living in your life. And so quick fixes, band-aids that just mask problems or bright, shiny objects will never get you where you want to go. Now, I am definitely a believer that things can change in an instant. Absolutely. We can have awarenesses, light bulb moments that completely change our life in an instant. And when we think about the pandemic, you know, this collective shared experience, for so many of us, life changed in an instant. Now, it doesn't have to be that heavy of an experience to change your life, but it's a really good illustrator of the fact that, you know, something can change in a moment and we have this big light bulb or awakening, and then it's about living it over time and being sure that we are keeping our promises to ourselves and coming back to what did we say in that moment that was important to us, and that wisdom that we woke up to and that value we created in that moment, and are we staying true to it over time? Because so often then just life happens, right? And we get back in the cycle of life and we get further and further away from that light bulb moment instead of fully integrating it into our beingness and into our vibration and the way that we are going about life. And a lot of times when we are doing work like this, we have to really look at what is hard or scary to confront in our lives. It's not about poking your pain with a stick over and over. It's not about staying in the shadow, but it is about having the courage to visit the shadow. Of course, then we want to come out and we want to make sure that we're bringing in plenty of good feeling and connecting with that high vibration as we ride that alignment and navigate that in our lives to keep that flow. But we have to be willing to face what is uncomfortable. And I just talked to someone recently as they're sharing with me, you know, going through these 5 steps, and she was like, this is hard work. She's going deep. And I'm like, yeah, it is. It's really hard work. A lot of times my work is not popular because it's not always easy, but it's always worth it when you are ready to really get to, it's about the heart of it and the root. Go into the heart and the root of what needs to come up to come out so that it can stop blocking your path, so that you can receive as you're building over time, but to bring it to you quicker, like we've already talked about. So when we're looking at what can be scary to face, it a lot of times can be about cutting away and what needs to die from our lives, kind of that birth, death, rebirth cycle in order to create the space. So again, this is about going back to safety and feeling safe to cut away what no longer serves us, whether that's people pleasing or boundary issues, self-worth, self-esteem, things like that, fear. And then a big part of this is also going into building discernment and cultivating discernment, especially around what feels icky versus what feels uncomfortable. Those are two very, very different states, but so often we can be in a place where it is hard to feel that very subtle difference. There can be such a subtle difference there. So being able to discern the difference, to know this is icky. There are so many predators out there. There are so many predators. I went down the rabbit hole of watching documentaries on predation in self-help, predators in yoga, like all of these different cults and spiritual predation going on. So we have to be very aware of, you know, anyone can say they're anything. And so what do we feel about that person? And is it icky, or are they just asking us to get uncomfortable for growth, or wherever that is happening in your life? So for today's soul work, it's really about just, how the hell does this feel to you? Honestly, how do you feel about looking deeper at your challenges? How do you feel about bringing in that bigger visionary feeling of what you want to create? Does that feel easy to you? Does it feel hard? Do you feel stuck somewhere? And what do you really need around that in order to connect with it? I would love for you to mark your calendar for Wednesday, May 5th at noon Central Time for our live group wrap-up call, whether you have tuned into all the steps or not. I would love to have you there so we can go over this again to really go into depth with it, have time to come together as a community and do a really great meditation to integrate and connect to our higher self, connect to that energetic piece of ourselves to bring in a deeper alignment. And I have so enjoyed doing this work with you. Thank you for showing up for yourself. That's always the biggest piece when you're getting to the heart and the root of yourself is just to show up for yourself. I am wishing you all the best. Thank you.